Ranos here, and welcome to Serial Space Engineers. In this episode, we'll take a look at the Freight Engineers version 0.09 by Sphizaan? I don't pronounce that wrong. I'm not sure if I pronounce that first bit. As well as the Warfare 2 DLC editions by Substitious. Now the V0.09 for the Freight Engineers is going to be very important because this is a beta mod. In other words, it's still in development. And all the blocks can't be used, which is kind of annoying. But the whole concept behind the mod is actually very interesting. Well, as interesting as containers can get. So anyway, how about we head over and take a look at the blocks inside it? There's quite a few. Some interesting ones that could be quite handy as well. For aesthetic reasons, that is. So, let's head on over. And first, our first one are the shelves. Which is just platforms on top of stilts. Three different sizes. One is single block. You got the double block. I jumped a bit too far there. And the last is the four block. So these are pretty much really elevated, you can stick things on top and whatnot, and yeah. I think it's more designed for these things to be stuck on top. But you know, they're the pallets. Because all these are in one group. And then you get this one. It's just an empty pallet. You put things on top of. Well, not in game, considering, you know, blocks. Block spacing and everything. But you can drop things on top of it if you want, like small ship stuff. And then here you have a pallet with boxes. Oh, what the? You can be accessed? I wish I did that sooner. I could have sworn these were all accessible. Okay, I'm annoyed that I can't figure out how to access the thing. Ow. You bugger. That's too close? No? There we go. Ah, 512 litres storage. Bit of a finicky one to get both access. Looks like I have to try and access the very center one. Which is a bit of a weird way to do it. And yeah, I don't believe any of these have conveyor access on the bottom. So yeah, you will have to access them yourself. But it makes it very interesting for like transporting items and whatnot. You know, for aesthetic reasons. And here you got a stack of pallets. Or startup. Then here you got some separate ones. One that's carrying a bunch of girders. Nicely stacked. One that's carrying a bunch of small steel tubes. Another carrying large steel tubes. I wonder if they'll add more as they develop the mod. Hope so. Pretty cool. I even have these individual stacks for small ships. Yeah, the small ship blocks over there. I never even checked the resource cost for these. Oh yeah. This requires a lot of large steel tubes. This requires a lot of small steel tubes, so not only will it make your place look better, it acts as practical storage, which is handy. So I'm guessing they may add more in the future to store more things. Ow. Oh, there's half of them gone. There's another one gone. I'm afraid of making this into screen Tyler. Balls! Yeah, if he wasn't using one as good as the one I am doing, then that probably wouldn't have disappeared. Oh yes, this one. And bunk! Here's another one. So yeah, you can just plop one of these down, have it used to store all the different items that you want. And hopefully in the future, they'll add more. Yeah, at the bottom, it's got 7 interior plates, 6 construction components, 5 small steel tubes, and 6 girders. Is that how much this needs? Yeah, that's just the price of a pallet. So you can build a bunch of these and have them down, and then when you want to actually store the 3 items that are currently available, you simply grind it up and pop it down. So this one, oh my, it's quite expensive. I guess it'll get more storage over time, something like that. We'll see how this block is developed in the future. And that's just multiples of the different items based on the amount of pallets that are currently here. So yeah, that's all of the large ship blocks available in this pack. That's mod. As for small ships, you get the pallet. This, you can actually put different blocks on. They put the cubes on, that on. Huh. Gives us a way to transport ship parts, I guess. But they will become functional. And then here are the shelves again, but for the small ships. You have the one block designed to be on a wall, because it's a shelf. You have the two block one designed for a wall, and the 3 block wide one, the 3 block wide shelf for the wall. Now there's no 2x2 one here, but oh well. Yeah, I think these shelf ones will be pretty handy in some small ships. Help you store a bunch of things. It makes me wonder, will they add more types of these? Similar to that. So I think this idea is actually pretty good. Like having these as an actual storage block, where you got to weld and grind to get the pieces and to store the pieces and whatnot like that. I think it's a pretty clever idea. Like I said earlier, it might be a good idea to have this individual stack here as a small ship block as well. You know, for storage purposes. I think it'll work pretty well. Especially if you use the pallet that's over there on the small ship. You can store multiple different things on there at the same time. So I think that'll be pretty good. Now, how about we move on to the additions? The mod adds more things to the Warfare 2 DLC. Thus, you will need to have Warfare 2 DLC, purchased. Otherwise, you can't use this mod. The mod basically adds some of the new styled weapons as turrets. Like the new Gatling gun as a turret, as well as the new missile launcher. Now, these are only available on large ships, so you won't be able to put these on small ones. Which is a bit of a shame, but oh well. But this one isn't the... well, it just pretty much doubles up the amount of cannons on the default vanilla one. And it also shoots a lot faster. What I noticed. I tested it earlier. Actually, yeah. Oh wait, I should really put down the vanilla one as a comparison. Hey, now you're Azimuth. Here you are. Yeah, unfortunately, these new state things aren't part of this pack. Bit of a shame, but oh well. Yeah, and you see, they are both very similar. So the other ones are kind of doubled up compared to this one. And I plop you there. We go here. We get to the vanilla. And control. That's how it shoots. If it's 2, that has a long reload time. But this one, you see, keeps on firing. About 26 rounds per load, and because I'm in creative, it doesn't need to reload. I guess it's a handy thing. And although I have had one problem with that one, is that it's a hitbox because of a bit of a problem. It makes it go boom. That's the only thing wrong with this one and that one at the moment is their hitbox. Their entire box which they need to be placed is their entire hitbox as well. It needs a bit of adjustment, but I'm sure it'll be fine. And you got this one, which is just the same as vanilla. I think it's the same one. And let me find the turret again. Yeah. Oopsie, too close. Just the same, but as you can clearly tell, it's been recolored. So the colors are different. Which I think looks pretty cool. Now, what if we were to change this color and skin? Let's do that and digital camouflage. And there we go. There we go. Let's go back to my default. Oopsie. As you see, that one pretty much colours that area as well, but this one doesn't. So yeah, it's just two different skins of the same weapon. This one... That doesn't look right. Alright then. Either way, it still functions the same way. Despite looking a bit weird. I didn't realize that was there. So yeah, as well, the build cost for this one, I believe is identical to its vanilla counterparts. Huh? I'm not sure what's happened there. But it appears that turret is a ghost. Four. Still functions properly. Oh, you. Luckily, I don't think these things can actually hurt things on the same grid. So the missile won't launch a car to hold myself blown up by now. You did get hurt. But yeah, that fire is just the same way as its vanilla counterparts. You know, the non-turret version. That you put on small ships. I still find it a shame you can't put a fixed Gatling turret on large ships. Would be fun. But oh well. So anyway, I don't know, let's check the build cost of these two compared to each other. It's 350 steel plates. 300 steel plates. 330 construction components. That is 280 construction components. 50 grids. 30 grids. 60 large tubes. 30 large tubes. You know, double the turrets. 30 motors. 20 motors. 40 computers. 20 computers. So this one with the double the amount of barrels, and the fact you can keep on rapid firing, is more expensive, as you'd expect. As for you, I think you just cost the same as the other rocket launcher. Just a different style. Which I personally think looks better. This one. Although, it also fires more rockets. So I guess it's gonna be more expensive. 30, 15, 10, 16, 6. Yeah, it costs the same. Yeah. This book is still a ghost. Ghost turret. Just imagine that. You find a ship coming at you, and it's hitting with lots of machine guns, and you try shooting at its guns to disable them, but you can't because of the ghost turrets. How infuriating would that be? Quite indeed. I'm also curious on why they're auto... Well, idling. It's not turned on for these. Eh, I guess that's how I might have set them. Anyway, I guess I should end this one here. And links for both mods will be in the description below. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.